This full lockdown is designed to act as a circuit breaker, to buy our contact tracers and testing systems time and understand the severity of this outbreak. I'd like to thank everyone for doing the right thing. Our roads are clearly quieter. Many people are staying home, limiting contact and reducing the ability for the virus to spread further. This is exactly what we wanted to achieve. It's clear that we can count on West Australians to do the right thing when it comes to COVID, especially getting tested. I'd like to thank everyone for their patience and understanding during these challenging times, especially with travel restrictions between Perth and Peel and the rest of the state. At our vehicle checkpoints around Perth and Peel, I can advise that up until 2 a.m. this morning, West Australian Police have stopped 17,393 people since our lockdown began, with 166 refused passage. Another 49 vehicles at the Northern Territory land border were not permitted to enter WA due to a lack of suitable quarantining accommodation. I know this is frustrating for those people involved, but given the situation in the Northern Territory, we need to maintain strong border controls to keep our community safe, especially the Kimberley region. This morning I can confirm that WA has recorded one new local case of COVID-19 overnight, in addition to three new overseas cases in our hotel quarantining system. Just to repeat, we have recorded one new local case of COVID-19 designated case 1028. Case 1028 is a 37-year-old male. Our contact tracing team is currently interviewing case 1028. At this point, it's too early to say exactly how he acquired the virus. Currently, there are two possible scenarios. On Tuesday morning, June 22, he attended the Mobius Health and Performance Gym in Joondalup during the same exposure period as case 1022. In addition to this, he also attended that same gym on Saturday, June 26, during the same exposure period as case 1023. Case 1028 did the right thing and went and got tested and quarantined on Sunday, June 27. That test returned a negative result. He subsequently developed symptoms, was retested yesterday, and has now returned a positive result. As a result of this new case, anyone who visited or worked at the Mobius Health and Performance Gym in Joondalup since Tuesday the 22nd until now and has not yet been tested or contacted by WA Health needs to do so immediately. It is extremely important that you get tested immediately and follow all of the quarantine instructions. It's important to note that case 1028 has been in quarantine and was not expected to have been infectious in the community. This is encouraging news. It also shows the importance of the restrictions that have been in place since we reacted swiftly on Sunday. I can also confirm that as of 8 p.m. last night, a total of 310 close contacts have been identified in this community cluster, of which 205 have tested negative so far. In addition, a total of 2,199 casual contacts have been identified, of which 701 have tested negative so far. It's important to highlight that nearly 1,800 of the casual contacts have been picked up through our Safe WA app. This just reinforces how important the Safe WA app is. I encourage everyone to keep using the app or signing in wherever possible. It's important to remember the numbers of close and casual contacts will continue to rise as new cases are found and are interviewed by our expert contact tracing teams and new exposure sites are added. I'd like to remind every West Australian to keep checking the exposure sites listed online. They can be found at wa.gov.au and the Healthy WA website. New locations and times are added regularly, and it's important that everyone stays informed of the latest locations. I can also report that 18,255 tests were conducted yesterday, a record daily number of tests for Western Australia. That's a great number and is testament to West Australians' dedication to doing the right thing. 43,675 tests have been done since Sunday, and we need to keep it up. In addition, we had 15,196 calls to the COVID hotline yesterday, a new record. We need as many West Australians as possible to get tested, whether they've been instructed to do so, have been to an exposure site, or are experiencing symptoms. The more people we get tested, the more confidence we can have when taking the next steps. Even if you've already returned a negative result and then developed symptoms, like case 1028, get tested again. I want to thank everyone for their patience. They are absolutely doing the right thing by getting tested. I can advise that we have additional testing capacity in the northern suburbs, including a number of drive-through clinics. I know there have been some long waits in the northern suburbs for testing. I want to thank everyone for their patience and for going out and getting tested. There is a wide range of testing locations available, and they're all listed online. It is a good reminder that there are other testing locations available around the metro area with shorter waits. Getting tested is one of the best ways to keep each other safe and get life back to normal as soon as possible. With regards to the Northern Territory gold mine outbreak, I can confirm the 175 mine workers who were tested in WA have all returned an initial negative test and are all undertaking 14 days of quarantine. They will all be required to be tested again. All other mine workers who did arrive in WA as close contacts have now left the state. These results are very pleasing. As we know, this mine outbreak is currently causing significant problems in other jurisdictions around Australia. With regards to public schools, attendance was understandably down yesterday, similar to the lockdown last year. We want every child to get a good education. Education is an essential service, and our school staff are essential workers. Yesterday, 66% of students across Perth and Peel attended school, compared to 90% in the same week last year. There are understandably lower levels of attendance at those schools closer to the outbreak in the northern suburbs. Many people staying home and waiting for test results have school-aged children. Lockdowns are naturally frustrating and difficult for everyone, but they're necessary. I wouldn't do it if the health advice didn't say it was the best way to handle the current situation as quickly and effectively as possible. And hopefully in the future, as more West Australians get vaccinated, they will no longer be required. I know many West Australians' thoughts are on what next week will bring, what it means for school holidays, their employment, their businesses. The next couple of days will tell us a lot, and I hope to have more to say later this week, as soon as we can. In the meantime, we just need to keep doing the right thing for each other, stay home if possible, stay safe, get tested, and importantly, get vaccinated. I'll now hand over to the Health Minister.
Thank you, Premier. Good morning, everyone. Can I begin today just with providing a shout out to all our great health staff who have been working on the front lines during this outbreak. Our health workers have been going above and beyond their normal roles. This includes the contact tracing teams, where we have over 100 people now working around the clock. Our testing clinics, which have been so busy. PathWest, which has been processing thousands of test results around the clock. The vaccination centres, which have really ramped up. In fact, can I thank everyone in our health system, particularly in our hospitals, where we're continuing to deal with unprecedented demand. You're all doing a great job. Yesterday was a very encouraging day on quite a few different levels. The fact we have only had one new related community case is encouraging. It appears we have caught case 1028's positive result very early on in his infection and while he was isolating. This is exactly why we have moved swiftly to try to stop the Delta outbreak in the northern suburbs as quickly as possible. But while I'm always optimistic, as you know, I'm always very cautious about COVID-19 because it is such an unpredictable and dangerous virus, particularly the Delta strain. So today is going to be another crucial day as we await the results of thousands of tests from yesterday. We all saw those long queues yesterday, so I want to thank everyone for their patience. I've heard that the testing clinics aren't as busy this morning, but please don't hesitate to get tested if you have any symptoms at all or have been to any of the exposure sites.